Hammer, wie du dich bewegst in dem Outfit. Hammer, einzigartig, unglaublich. Hammer, du weißt, dass du über...
Hallo alle, in this episode we will be talking about modal verbs. This is something that sounds really complicated, but like a lot of grammar concepts can be broken down. So in English, we have modal verbs like can, will, should, etc., etc., etc. And in German it's the same thing. So a modal verb is called a modal verb in part because it can only really be used with another verb in a sentence. So, for example, I can ask, wann kannst du kommen? So when can you come? For example, to my birthday party. So what's the modal verb here? It's this kannst, right? So I couldn't say wann kannst du and then leave it at that, because it would just raise the question, well, what can I? You need something that you can do, right? So you get the picture of why these are special. So they always have to be combined with another verb, whether that's there in the sentence, like this one is, or whether it's implicit. So for example, we say all the time, kannst du Deutsch? So, can you, and then implicitly, speak German, right? So, implicitly, we have sprechen. And just because this is such a common sentence, German speakers just tend to leave that extra verb out. So, we see that modal verbs always need that other idea, at least, of another action present with them. You need to be wooding, coulding, shoulding something, right? So let's make our chart, or just give a list of the modal verbs in German. Now, if you are in the Berliner Platz textbook, this is chapter 8, but I'm going to be throwing in verbs from additional chapters just so you have the whole list. We have können, and you can repeat after me, können, dürfen, müssen, wollen, and sollen. So, können, dürfen, müssen, wollen, sollen. So three of these have umlauts, right? So können, basically it means to can. Can you do something? Can I do something? Dürfen is to be allowed to do something. So can do something, for example. Müssen is to have to do something. Wollen is to want something or to do something. Sollen is to be supposed to do something. So you can see that this do something, allowed to do something, have to do something, want something or do something, supposed to do something, this is where we're talking about the extra verb that you will almost without fail always see with a modal verb, because otherwise they wouldn't be special. So let's do some conjugation, and I want you to check out the pattern that you will probably see developing. So on this side we have our pronouns. Ich, du, er, and just er, sie, es is implicit there. Wir, ihr, z, and then the plural z is implicit there. Okay, let's start out with können. So ich kann, and you can repeat after me, du kannst, er kann, wir können, it's different, ihr könnt, und sie können. Great. Let's try another one. How about müssen? So ich Muss, du musst, er, sie, es muss, wir müssen, ihr müsst und sie müssen. Seeing the pattern yet? I bet you are. Let's do dürfen. So, ich darf, du. Maybe you can even fill in the rest. Er, sie, es darf, wir dürfen, ihr dürft und sie dürfen. Okay. So, what's the pattern that you see thus far? So, all of these verbs in the infinitive, we can write the infinitive above here. So, this is können, müssen, dürfen. So, what do you notice? So, in these, in the first three pronouns, the umlaut, so all these have umlauts in the infinitive, the umlaut is dropped, right? So, it's really only beginning with the wir form that the umlaut comes back, and then ihr, and then sie. So, there you have it. That's the pattern. Now, let's try conjugating the other verbs that don't have umlauts in the infinitive. We have wollen, and then we'll have sollen. So ich will. Uh-oh, different. Du willst, er, sie, es will. Wir wollen, ihr wollt, und sie wollen. Right? So this has a different stem for those first three forms, will. And then we have sollen. Ich soll, du sollst, er, sie, es soll, wir sollen, ihr sollt, sie sollen. So that one is pretty straightforward. So do what you can to memorize this table and to recognize that if the verb, the modal verb in the infinitive, contains an umlaut, like können, müssen, dürfen, then that umlaut will remain out of the way in the ich, du, er, sie, es forms, but will come back in the wir, ihr, sie forms. So it's time to do some examples. How about the first one with a familiar subject if you've been watching my other videos? Ich will einen Dachshund adoptieren. Ich will einen Dachshund adoptieren, weil sie so süß sind. So keep your eyes on that sentence, even though I'm drawing a cute doggy here. And see if you can spot the two verbs and which one is the modal verb. So, of course, it is will. Now, just a quick aside, a lot of English speakers will confuse the conjugations of wollen with the future tense because in English we say something like, I will adopt a dachshund, but that's a completely different story, right? Because I don't know if I will or not, but I want to. So, what the sentence means is, I want to adopt a dachshund, right? So here we have our two verbs, and remember that if I just deleted that second verb there, you wouldn't get the full story of what that modal verb is about, right? So we need that other verb. So how about another example? Der Tyrannosaurus muss Dinos fressen. Dinos, short for Dinosaurio. And we know that he's a carnivore. And so, of course, he has to fressen other dinos. Fressen is the German verb that means to eat, but it's like to gobble up, like an animal would eat something. Dinos, roar. Der Tyrannosaurus frisst. Stem changing verb. I'm just using this all as an excuse to keep talking so I can draw this Tyrannosaurus. So, muss Dinos fressen, deshalb hat blutige Zähne. Ah. He has no choice, he's a carnivore. So, again, the German verb müssen means to have to. It doesn't mean exactly the same thing as must in English. It's a different, slightly different meaning. He has to. So, even if he really doesn't want to, maybe he's conflicted, but he has to because he's a carnivore and he has those teeth. So, müssen. So, let's go to a few a little bit more banal examples because I want you guys to understand this. So let's make a new context. Die Wohnung. Die neue Wohnung, because this is the topic of your chapter 8 in Berliner Platz 1. So think about all the things that you can do with a new apartment, that you have to do, that you should do, or that you're not allowed to do. So because it's more fun to talk about what you're not allowed to do, we'll talk about that. So what are you not allowed to do if you are renting? Well, if you live in the United States, you're probably not allowed to smoke, so ich darf nicht rauchen. Ich darf nicht in der Wohnung rauchen. So, again. Rauchen und rauchen verboten. So, ich darf nicht rauchen. So, this means I am not allowed to smoke, right? So dürfen means to be allowed to do something. So we can take another example. Wir, like you and your roommates, wir sollen die Wohnung putzen, to clean, right? So you are supposed to clean your apartment, of course, natürlich. Naturally, I'm sure you all do a great job of cleaning your apartments. So, what's something that you could do? So, let's say you can do something, you and your friends can do something that you couldn't do at your parents' house. Wir können mehr Alkohol trinken. And of course, all viewers of this video are over 21 years old. If you are American, otherwise, I don't care. PBR. Jawohl. So, wir können mehr Alkohol trinken. You are able to, right? So, können is to be able to do something. And something else that you want to do. Wir wollen unsere Freunde einladen. Einladen means to invite, right? You want to have your friends over. So is this making sense? So again, modal verbs, they're fun. So, danke und bis zum nächsten Mal. Tschüss.